In this video, we'll go over AI Builder, which is a new capability of Power Platform. As you know, Power Apps allows business users to easily create applications for your business. Whether you're an experienced AI developer or business expert, AI Builder now provides a way for those app makers to intuitively train AI solutions and leverage the pre-built AI Builder modules and easily incorporate it into your existing applications and workflows. This allows any user of that application to harness the benefits of AI right from within their app. AI Builder provides a similar experience as well for Flow, so anybody can add intelligence to their workflows without any coding. AI Builder is a no-code capability that spans the Power Platforms and Dynamic 365 applications. As a capability of Power Platform, it natively integrates into the common data service and leverages the over 230 available data connectors to onboard business-critical data coming from external sources. Using the intuitive guided experience, you can use AI Builder to create and customize AI models and easily consume the results right from your existing apps. There are four models available today: prediction, which is in general availability, object detection, form processing, and text classification, which are all in public preview. Now let's take a look at how we can make, manage, and integrate AI into our apps and workflows. We'll walk through how to use the wizard and how we can share, export, and a few examples of integration within apps and workflows. We'll first take a look at the prediction model. The first thing you need to do is to make sure you have your historical business data, the outcomes that you've used in the past. And then you can use our easy-to-use point-and-click experience to create your model. Let's first take a look at Power Apps. As you can see, AI Builder has been incorporated into the left-hand navigation. There's the build area, which shows the various templates that you can use in order to create the various models. And then secondly, the models area. This is where you can manage your models and see what models you've built previously. We'll take a look at that later. Let's take a look at prediction and build a model. Right now, I'm going to assume for a moment that I'm a marketer, and what I want to find out is which of my customers have a higher chance of purchasing from me. So I'm going to create an intent to purchase model. As you'll see here, it will explain to you what you need in order to create this model. In this case, we need the historical outcomes from previous data showing users who have purchased and those who haven't. Now, in the next section, what we'll do is to select the entity where that data is stored. In this case, it's in my online purchase entity. And I'm going to choose this field, purchase status, which is where I have stored in the past those who have made purchases and those who haven't. Now, we've also provided this mapping area where you can map values to a yes or no so that you can have a direct correlation to the prediction overall. Now, in this area, this is where the rest of the fields of that entity will be provided to you, and you can decide which of these has the most influence on your model. We believe that most people may not know exactly how the data affects their model, so we've pre-selected those that we think are most interesting for you. Now you can always go in, deselect, or select others as you wish. In this next area, it will show what is the overall summary of what you've chosen so far. You've chosen the historical outcome of purchase status and the entities and fields, 19 of them, within this entity. Now we'll go ahead and train. Training just takes a couple minutes. While the model is training, let's take a look at the models page. On this page, you will see all of the models that I have created or that have been shared with me. From here, you can go and easily take action, whether that is to delete a model, look at the details of your model as far as its performance and if it's published, and you can share. We'll look at sharing a little bit later. For right now, we're going to take a look at the model that we've just created. So now that my model has finished training, let's take a look at the results. In this case, my model got a 63%. What do I think about this? What does this mean? This is an accuracy score. So I've taken some of the data that has been provided, and we hold that aside so that we can test it once the model is completed. This means that 63% of the time, I'm getting the answers correct. So I'm going to publish this model. So I'll go ahead and publish. Now that I've seen the score, if I want, I can get a little bit more detail by looking at these top influencers. These are all of the key data points that have influenced the model and its creation. This allows you to actually take a look at the different values and see, does this make sense to you? In this case, this makes a lot of sense to me, so I'm going to move forward with my model. Now that I have created and published my model, I'm going to go back into my models because I want to share with a colleague. All right, let's take a look at how to share models. If I go into my models, I can take a look here at the different actions I can take, and here it says share. So I can easily just put in the name of the person who I want to share it with and press share. And just like in Power Apps and Flow, I'm able to share this model to other colleagues. Another thing that we can look at is how to import and export these solutions. So first I'll go into solutions, and I've created a new solution here called Purchase Intent. You can create a new solution here. I've already created this in advance. Within Purchase Intent, I'm going to add my AI model that I wanted to actually import and export. In this case, I chose my intent to purchase model. Once I added that, what I needed to do was to add required components. And what that will do is to look through the requirements and the dependencies. And in this case, it brought in my online shopper intention entity. Now that that's completed, I can just simply choose the solution, choose export, and it will create a zip file for me. Once I have that file, I can go into my other environment and just import that solution directly. With object detection, you can build an AI model to help you automatically identify, locate, and count things in an image. You can use this model in Power Apps to extract information from pictures you take with a camera. Let's take a look at an example. For object detection, again, it will show you what you need. In this case, it's images. Because object detection requires us to tag a lot of images in order to create a model, I have actually taken a first step forward. So here you'll see I've already selected the entity with the names that I want, and I've also uploaded all of my images. The next step is to tag my images. Here we'll go ahead and do some examples of tagging these images. In this case, I am tagging as Rose T. And one of the things that you'll notice is as I'm tagging, I can either create a bounding box using the easy UI, or there will also be bounding boxes that is predefined for you if you choose to use that. As you see on the right, it'll tell you how many images you've already tagged. When you're done tagging, it'll show you the totals of what you have tagged and how many you need. So you need 15 images for each one that you want to detect. Let's go now to a model that I've already created. This is the teabag model that I've created for somebody who is doing an inventory of teabags. Unlike in prediction where we had the influencer scores, in object detection we have something called a quick test. So I'll choose an image that I have to test. So let me choose, here is one of the images that I have. And as you'll see, what it shows me is that it has 97% confidence that this is cinnamon and 99% that this is mint. Now let's take a look at an app that I created. So this is my tea detecting app. One of the things that you'll see is I've added this new control that we have. If you choose the insert menu, you will now see AI Builder and a number of different controls. In this case, I've added the object detector control. Once I've added the control, you just configure that with the model that you want to choose to use. In this case, I used the teabag model that I've created. Now we can run this and you can practice and see if I choose an image, it will again go through, analyze it, and tell me what it saw. In this case, I wanted to have counts, and it shows me one minty and one cinnamon tea. Now, this can be deployed now to all of the applications that I have, and all of my users of my application can take advantage of this model and this detection capability. You can also use AI Builder to increase your productivity using the forms processing solution. Using this model, you can create intelligent workflows that will process forms and automatically extract relevant information. Let's take a look at an example. In this case, I'm going to be taking a number of invoices. Oftentimes, we receive invoices in email. Let's create a model to extract information from those invoices and then set up a flow to make that an automated process. So I've gone ahead and started an invoicing model for us. I've already uploaded my invoices. What I'll do next is to decide what are the fields that I want extracted. In this case, I want a from and a to field. I want what the items are, and I want the information around the cost, tax, and subtotal. These are the areas that I want to have extracted for me. So now that I'm done, I've chosen those, and it'll go ahead and train a model for me. Once the model is trained, I can go ahead and in the details page, much like in object detection, it will provide me an experience where not only does it allow me to see how many form fields I've trained, but also allows me to do a quick test. The quick test can be used by using a already existing invoice that you might have that you want to see how well does it really do. So in this case, I'm uploading an invoice, and within a couple seconds, it will already identify those fields that I've already trained. Now I can go ahead and just press publish, and in seconds, it will be published and will be available for me to start using in any of my workflows or models. Here you see I have an app that I created that I want to scan invoices and actually extract some of the information. So what I've done is I have inserted my form processing control, and I've also associated it with my invoice model. I can run this and choose and again analyze by using an invoice that I already have, run it, and it will extract the information right here within my app. So you could have a mobile app or any sort of app that you can include this and extract the information that you want to see directly. Another way is to actually create a flow. In this case, I've created a flow that says, once I've extracted my information and I've included here the model that I created for invoices, if anything is greater than $1,000, then I want to send a mail that it needs to be approved. If not, just approve it automatically. Just like that, I've been able to take what was a very cumbersome process and automate it and really simplify and optimize my workflows. Text classification takes any snippet of text based on historical data you provide. You can streamline your business by automatically tagging new text. For example, you can use an AI model in your workflow to classify new customer feedback as you receive them. Let's go ahead and build a text classification model. In this case, let's assume we're a hospital and we'd like to improve our healthcare customer service. We can use an AI model to automate that customer feedback and classify it within our workflows and send it to the right places. Let's go ahead and create a text classification model. Here it shows us what we need. In this case, we need to have some text entries or comments that we've received from people, and what are the tags that we want to tag them with. The next thing we need to do is to choose what are the comments and from which entity. So I'll go ahead and select my entity here, and choose Comments. Here you'll see it extracts the comments from my entity. In the next, I'll just be choosing what are the tags that I want. So it chooses from that same entity. And at the next step is to decide, do you have a delimiter? In this case, I was using commas, so I'll select that. So here you'll see the combination of your text and tags mapping that you have submitted. If that looks good to you, you can move on to the next. Here, you can choose what language you actually want to do your text classification in. You can see we have multiple languages that are supported. In this case, I'm going to choose English. And now it's simply training my model. Now that the model has finished training, let's take a look at the quick test. In this case, the quick test is a little bit different. Here, we can just add any text that we want to test out. And we'll test it. And it believes that it is associated with the staff tag. That's exactly what I was thinking. So we'll move forward and close this out, and time for us to publish this model. So let's take a look at a flow that we've created. In this case, after a patient leaves our hospital, we always send them a follow-up email. Within that email, they get a survey where they can respond to tell us about how their visit was. Once we get their response, you'll see that here we can actually extract the information from the form and leverage the model that we just created to appropriately tag the text. Depending on how that has been tagged, then we will route it off to the correct department. In this case, you can see that if it is equal to staff, we will send it off to the staff management. In just a few minutes, we've been able to create a model, add it to our flow, and really simplify what was a very manual task. So now we've just gone through the creation of a number of different models and showing different examples of integrating AI into existing Power Apps and workflows. All of these were based off of models that we created. There's another kind of AI builder functionality that we have directly incorporated into Power Apps, and that is the business card reader. Okay, so let's see this in action. We're going to go ahead, choose Insert, go to AI Builder, and there's a component there called Business Card Reader. We'll insert that into my app that I have created. And now that it's there, I will put it how I want it in my app. And just like that, I can go ahead and use it. I'll give it a test. And just like that, I've been able to extract the information and add it to my contact database. As you can see, it is now very easy to build your own intelligence using the Intuitive Wizard interface across many different AI solutions. Make your workflows and applications more efficient with AI today. Try AI Builder and share your feedback.